Quadratic functions is a relatively easy topic to steer through. After all, there are only three different ways to represent quadratic functions. So, as the driver, you're only required to make a maximum of three different stops to pick up all the relevant information you need. The problem with that is if you approach this in a hurried and haphazard manner, information is gathered inefficiently, leading to you chasing your tail and eventually failing spectacularly. On the other hand, being overly cautious and deliberate could be a waste of time too. Why don't we break this down instead into a more systematic approach to emerge in the cleanest and quickest way possible? General town is ideally where you always want to start off at. The value of A tells you whether the curve looks like a smiley or sad face, and the C value shows where the y-intercept is. But as this example shows, there are limitations to what you can sketch. So we move on. Roots are helpful when your quadratic function resembles this format and close in linear brackets. To get here from general town, there are usually three paths: cross-factorize, quadratic formula, or completing the square. In this case, the A value indicates the shape of the curve, and the roots 2 and negative 3 can be read off like so. Look how complicated this formula is. Hence, make the vertex your last stop. You get here either by brute force of using the formula or by completing the square. The three pieces of data here are your curve shape, your line of symmetry, and the maximum or minimum value. We'll now discuss the three possible routes to take here. For an example like this, we start by picking out the straightforward values in general town, namely the shape of curve and y-intercept. This should only take up a mere 10 seconds of your life. Next, pick your preferred path to obtaining the two x-intercepts of 2 and negative 3. This should take approximately 1 minute. After which, come to the realization that the line of symmetry is smack in the middle of both roots. There is no need to apply a complicated formula here. Instead, just take the average of both x-intercepts for the line of symmetry. Common sense dictates that x equals to 0 has to be on the right of x equals to negative 0.5. So now I can fit in my y-axis. And since the y value lies on the curve, I can simply substitute the line of symmetry value of negative 0.5 into the quadratic expression to obtain the minimum value of the curve. With the line of symmetry value of negative 0.5 and a minimum value of negative 6.25, I can reverse engineer the vertex format with the given values. In conclusion, pass through all three stops in green. Start from the general form and obtain the roots, after which save time by finding the average of the roots to obtain the vertex of the curve. This entire route should take you approximately 3 minutes. With one x-intercept, the route becomes much simpler. For this example, we once again start from the general form and unpack the A and C values. In this case, a sad face curve with a y-intercept of negative 4. Tackle the roots by cross-factorizing and we end up with one x-intercept. Guess what? That's going to be your line of symmetry too. Since the curve is symmetrical at that point, we can state the line of symmetry as x equals 2 with a maximum y value of 0. After labeling the y-intercept of negative 4 from the general form, that's everything you need for this curve. So, here's what the path looks like. After your mandatory stop for the general form, obtain the only root and label that as your vertex. There is no need to waste time obtaining a vertex anymore. The last path you ever need here happens if there are no x-intercepts. In this example, I go through the same routine and obtain an A value of negative 1 and a C value of negative 3. Cross-factorizing or calculator magic does not yield any roots here. So what I do instead is to apply the corresponding values of A, B, and C with negative 1, positive 1, and negative 3. Alternatively, you can attempt the complete the square method if formulas aren't your thing. This might take a while, but if everything goes right, you should be able to read off a line of symmetry value of half. Knowing where x equals to half is will help you pin down the y-axis on its left. What's left now is reading off the maximum y value of negative 11 over 4. Coupled with the y-intercept of negative 3 we found earlier, common sense suggests that the x-axis should be high above the curve, which totally makes sense. After all, there are no x-intercepts at all. This last path looks more tedious, but remember that you save time by avoiding the roots. Divert your path towards only the vertex, and you still end up with all the information you need. To recap, there are a maximum of 3 stops to collect all your relevant information. Use the number of roots to guide you through the optimal path, and with some common sense, it will be a downhill ride to piece things together.